Reigning world and Olympic champion. Neither of them have won a Super Series title so far this year. Then we finish with mixed doubles, and we've got the Olympic champions, Tantowi Ahmad and Liliana Natsir, trying to regain the title that they won here 3 years ago. Well, as far as the men's doubles Super Series standings are concerned, despite for a second Super Series running, Govi Shem and Tanwi Kyong losing in the first round, they will remain as number ones. As far as Gideon and Sukumoljo are concerned, well, they're currently at number four. Whether they win or lose today's final, they'll go up two places to number two, which will push down Kimura and Sonoda to number three. And Pratama and Suwadi will get pushed down two places, because Chai Biao and Hong Wei, who were semi-finalists here, will go up one place to number four. As far as the men's doubles draw is concerned, well, by quarterfinal stage, we only had four different nations involved. Three Danish pairs, two Chinese pairs, two Japanese pairs, and one Indonesian pair. By semi-finals, we only had three seeds and three different nations. We had two Chinese pairs, but both Chinese pairs lost in the semi-final stage. So we have the former champions, Bo and Mogensen, up against the Indonesians, Gideon and Sukumoljo. So both pairs seeded. As you can see, Bo and Mogensen, the higher seeds at four. Former European champions, Olympic silver medalists, World Championship silver medalists. The Danes have had an exceptional career so far. But what an exceptional year the Indonesians have had. Marcus Fernaldi and Kevin Sukumoljo, two Super Series titles this year from two finals. They've never lost a Super Series tournament final. For Matthias Bo and Carsten Mogensen, this a fourth final here at the China Open. The two-time former champions, they won in 2011 and again a year later. On both those occasions, they beat Koreans in the final. The one time they lost in the final here at the China Open was back in 2008, and once again it was Korean opponents. Well, the Danes, this is their third final of the year, and their first two finals, they won them both, the US Grand Prix Gold and the last Super Series event prior to this China Open, the French Super Series, which sadly ended with an injury to Bodo Nisara. And we hear he's making good progress with his rehabilitation after his knee injury, and that's very good to hear. As far as the Indonesians are concerned, trying to become the first pair this year to win three Super Series titles. Well, you have to go back to 2007 for the last Indonesian winners here at the China Open. 9 years ago, it was Marcus Kido and Hendra Setiawan who won the China Open men's doubles title. There is Marcus Fernaldi Gideon. He is 25 years of age, born in Jakarta. He and his partner are at a career high of seven at the moment, enjoying their second week at number seven in the world ranking. So to 21-year-old Kevin Sanjaya Sukumoljo, born in Banguwangi, easternmost end of Java. Serves as a port, doesn't it, between Java and the island of Bali? I seem to remember that. This is their first appearance here at the China Open as a pair. And in the second round, they beat the Olympic bronze medalists Marcus Ellis and Chris Langridge. In the quarterfinal, they beat an exciting young Japanese pair, Huki and Kobayashi. And then in the semi-final against Chai Biao and Hong Wei, who'd been in the final of this event for the last 2 years, they saved three match points in that second game before eventually winning it 26-24. In fact, they came from 12-17 down in that second game, having lost the first. That was a remarkable comeback by the Indonesians. So to Carsten Mogensen, he's 33 years of age, born in Roskilde. And he and his partner are former world number ones. The left-handed Matthias Boll, 36 years of age now, born in Frederikssund. This is their fourth final, as I say, but former world number ones, 62 weeks in total as world number ones. And they, on their road through to today's final, were troubled by a pair promoted from the qualifying in the first round from Chinese Taipei. And since then, well, I hope you were able to digest that. Since then, they've got through their matches very quickly indeed, including a quarterfinal against the number 8 seeds, Komura and Sonodo, and in the semi-final against Liu Cheng and Jiang Nan. This is the second meeting between the two pairs. The first time they met was in the first round of the Malaysian Super Series last year. Hour and 1 minute needed for that first round encounter that went to three games. 21-15 in the deciding game it was to the Danish pair.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Carsten Mogensen and Marius Boll Tema. And my left, Markus Ferrandi Kilian, Kevin Stantia Sukamujo, Indonesia. Marius Boll served to Kilian. Love play.
So whichever pair, oh dear, that's an ominous start, isn't it, from the left-handed Matthias Boll. Whichever pair wins today will create a little record this year, because Boll and Mogensen are trying to become the first pair this year to win back-to-back men's doubles Super Series titles. And as far as the Indonesians are concerned, if they win, they're the first pair this year to win three Super Series titles this year. Well, apart from this Danish combination winning the title here twice, one other Danish pair have won the men's doubles here at the China Open. And I think that may have been when you were coaching them, Steen, 2003. Lars Porsker and Jonas Rasmussen.
Yeah.
Oh, he's quick, isn't he? Sukamuljo.
Fun to watch two Indonesian players here, and they were in trouble yesterday against Chai Biao and Hong Wei. They really had them more or less locked down, but managed to come back.
Yeah, we were just about counting them out, weren't they?
Yeah.
12-17 down in the second game, having lost the first.
And having been totally out of the match. They hadn't had anything. Two extremely fast players, not that tall. I the Danes, they're going to have really, really good shot quality if they want to win this match. And by that I mean they need to control the rallies. I don't think they can afford to go into some sort of dogfight with the Indonesians.
Well, there's a challenge here. By Bo Mogensen. Where did they think they are? They thought it was the centre line that it was out. Because I was going to say that was certainly long enough into the service box. So, first challenge of this men's doubles. Now, what does Hawkeye say? I have to say, I thought it was in, but I mean, I wasn't particularly looking at that.
It's probably always going to be really close. I mean, there's no one serving 5 or 10 centimetres wide, so.
No.
And probably a close call.
And I tend to look at the front service line anyway.
Yeah,
it was
that's
out.
A good challenge.
Good challenge, yeah. Very good challenge.
So it's over. 3-6.
Oh, my goodness.
Great reactions by.
7-7.
Gideon.
Well, you were alluding to this earlier in the day, weren't you, about the mind games and...
Yeah, and the umpire is in for a tough task.
Yeah. It's a great serve.
And it's over 4-7.
Because I'm sure the Danes, they want to take their time here. Don't want to play a fast-paced match.
Ooh, challenge.
That's a challenge the
that's
other way.
That's definitely going to be a challenge. Surely that was in. Let's have a look.
I'm glad I didn't have to call it.
Yeah, it's quite deceptive when we're on an angle, isn't it?
Oh, it's just out.
It was just out. We were noticing in Denmark, weren't we, Steen, how difficult it was when we were on an angle to really judge the lines.
5-7.
They've got to be careful here, the Danes, because they are lifting a bit flat. Now, Carsten Mogensen is outside of the picture delivering the shuttle to the Indonesians by trying a high lift. And we saw that Chai and Hong, they were quite successful with their high lifts yesterday. Yes, that's what I've been suspecting throughout this tournament, that a number of the services from Kevin Sukumoyo are short. We can't see from that one that I was right. We can just say that this one was short. There's the high lift.
Whoops.
Well played.
Brilliant. And we've actually had a rally over six shots.
Almost needed a stadium announcer telling the audience this was a rally.
Oh, challenge that, yes. I thought that was in.
Marvel challenges Paul off.
You weren't convinced.
I just think it's
that's in.
Doubtful. It's one of the difficult ones that slides. There it was.
Mm. Good challenge.
They're really, really difficult to judge correctly.
Yeah, yeah. Very good serve.
Det er meget noget, vi skal blive ved med at være opmærksom på at bevæge os, selvom der er mange toiletter, der ikke er så lange. Ikke? Vi skal frem og have fat i det der, når de udfordrer os, hvad det er for en sætte bolden. Og så kommer vi under, så hejser den op, og så slår til, så må vi slå ind ud, hvis det er. Vi har ikke rigtig været tæt på at være nu. Ellers er det fint at arbejde. Men hvis vi får chancen, så bygger op, selvom der er en kæmpe der. En svær opsamling er meget god, den der lige der linjen. Den anden tror jeg er okay. Det får jeg.
So the advice there, Steen?
The Danes to keep moving, keep having good movements, even though some of the rallies are really, really short. If they're in trouble, then just lift it. Oh,
my goodness me! What on earth was that?
That's the wildest smash I've seen in a very, very long time. Or cut, or whatever it was. Maybe he was indecisive about what he wanted to do.
Yeah, sorry, I interrupted you there.
Once in a while, just played a high defensive shot to the baseline, and that's what I said. If it goes out, it goes out. I mean, we've not even been close yet by playing long. Well, they also said something about who they were targeting the most in the defense, but I couldn't hear who it was. They felt that one of the players from the Indonesian pair had really good flat defense. Good coverage by Matthias Ball.
Well, they've won all 4 points since the mid-game interval.
Yeah. And it starts up with good services.
Thank you.
That's it.
Short.
Great play by the Danes. Very patient attack by Carsten Mogensen, and then eventually he gets Mathias Boe activated, and Boe's smash is the left-handed smash, is doing a lot of damage to the Indonesian side.
This is extraordinary, isn't it?
What is it? Six points?
Six straight points. Yeah.
Boe is doing a really good job of serving and playing a really, really good third shot.
Comes to an end, but those seven straight points, a very different complexion and feel on this opening game.
Yeah. So come on, looking at the umpire. Oh, that would have been short.
He was committed to it though, wasn't he?
14.
This is where I feel that Carsten Mogensen is not getting ready to receive. And I mean, they've played two shots. What is it?
Yeah.
That's where I feel the umpires needs to be strict. Also, in order to keep men's doubles interesting, because it's so uninteresting watching these long breaks.
Yeah. I agree.
But it's a integrated part of the Danes' pre-rally routine, whether they're serving or they're receiving. And
But we've been talking about it for years, and I have a feeling that because of their status in world terms, four of them are world number ones, they're so highly ranked, that umpires have let them get away with it and get into the sort of...
I think so. And, I mean, they're not to blame. The umpires... not to blame if they feel that the rules are being broken and not do anything about it.
Broken or even exploited.
Yeah.
15.
Yeah, there's real hesitation, wasn't there, between the two Danes. That's surprising. You were talking about the fact that they formed their partnership in 2004, so this is their 13th year together.
You can see that it's getting to the Indonesians.
Yeah.
And here it is again. I mean, it's two shots. So there's nothing else to do than just get ready to receive the serve.
Good serve.
16-15.
How they want to tackle it, the Indonesians. One way of doing it is simply just launching the serve and then getting the Danes to say, hey, we're not ready. And then the umpire is forced to make a decision. Who do you want to complain against?
That's a brilliant serve. Yeah, Bo knows it, because otherwise he would have challenged. Oh, that one was short. That seemed to bob, didn't it?
Yeah. Excellent combination from the Danes.
Set play from the left and right hander.
Totally set play. Hitting on the outer side of Sukumoglio. Very difficult to get it across, and he plays it directly into the forehand of Matthias Bo.
Shoulder of Matthias Bo.
And we have to say, apart from that run of points the Danes had, it's the Indonesians who's dominated the few rallies that there's been. Nice. Big miss from Bo there. I'm not sure he expected a smash from Carsten Mogensen. We saw earlier that he'd played a lot of drop shots.
Yeah, well, we just saw a replay there from a couple of rallies ago. That's gone long.
80-90.
What a good return.
Yeah.
Oh, standard
in. Clearly in.
Yeah. Well, they're challenging, but I think that's a forlorn hope.
Or what? No.
Ooh.
We are in a bad position, Jill, to see those shots. I think it might be out.
Now it caught the line.
Oh. Well, it was definitely worth the challenge.
Yeah, it was indeed.
Very, very important time of the match.
Because it's now two game point opportunities for the Indonesians. Opening game to the number seven seeds, Gideon Marcus Finaldi and Kevin Sanjaya Sukumoglio. 21-80, opening game in 21 minutes.
Bagus, ya. Jadi kayak asal lewatin, ya. Tapi kalau mau selalu siap, belakang siap, masih silap.
So the Indonesians won game to the good, 21-18. And as so often with men's doubles, we've had some very short, sharp rallies. But Steve, when you look back on the former champions here at the China Open, men's doubles, and especially the Indonesian pairs, it's a who's who of all-time greats.
Yeah.
You've got Kido and Setiawan, Ricky and Rexy, Ricky Sabaja and Rexy Maniki, Rudy Gunawan and Bambang Supriyanto, Chandra Wajaya and Sigit Budiarto.
Tony Gunawan, what about him?
I don't think he did win it.
No.
And
he changed his partners so yes. so quickly.
Oh, that's quick. That is quick.
So incredibly fast with the rackets, both Indonesian players. And I don't think the drift has that much influence in this match. I think the Danes now feel that, okay, we can lift a little bit better. Yeah, maybe you can, but you shouldn't.
Yeah.
That's well played.
Lazua. I guess the other coach is with...
Daniel Jorgensen.
Yep. Going through the warm-up routine. Next match on court. It's the men's singles final. Targeting that forehand defense of the left-hander. Oof. Pulled out. Oh, my goodness. Well, he's missed a couple of sitters today, hasn't he?
Yeah.
That's very, very uncharacteristic.
Yeah, I guess it's perhaps the implied pressure that the Indonesians get so much back and they're so fast and unpredictable in their game.
Mm.
Hey! Demisova, 5-3.
A good start to the second game for the Danes.
Oh, my goodness me. I don't believe it. Where on earth did they extend that rally? Says change the shuttle. Danes didn't want to.
Server 4-6.
First time since that streak of points to the Danes in the first game that the Indonesians returned back at Matthias Boll. They solved it
5-6.
From, 15-10 in the first game by when Boll was serving, simply just returned to Carsten Mogensen.
Mm.
This was the first time they played back at him at the net.
Backhand.
Interesting, Matthias Boll and Carsten Mogensen, they're not sharing a room in this tournament. They're actually not sharing a hotel either, because Matthias Boll chose to move away from the official hotel.
So they like their own space when not on court.
Yeah, exactly.
Nothing wrong with that.
No.
That I thought that Kevin Sanjaya Sulkamoljo was going to play it. When we were on the bus coming over here, Steen, you were telling me about Boa Mogensen's chances of perhaps qualifying for the Super Series finals.
7-0.
Yeah, they're in competition with the two other Danish pairs, as Denmark can only qualify two pairs for the Super Series, and their chances are getting better. Of course, they would be even better if they won this tournament. They have to finish, if they win this tournament, they have to finish two rounds ahead of Skorup and Astrup. That means that if Skorup and Astrup were to lose the first round, they can afford to lose the quarterfinal and still qualify. If they lose this match, they have to finish three rounds ahead of Skorup and Astrup.
And of course, this Danish pair are three times winners of the Super Series finals, 2010-12. Three consecutive titles they won at the Super Series finals, so it's been one of their lucky events. They will desperately want to go to Dubai. But then, as we were saying earlier, so does everybody.
Yeah.
That's a great shot.
And what an achievement it would be for the Danes, considering that Carsten Mogensen has been out for so long with his brain aneurysm.
Yeah. I really didn't believe he'd ever get back to international badminton again, and he's not just got back. I mean, he's won two tournaments since then.
I think we saw them in Denmark Open where they actually showed some really good play, and there were signs of something good, and therefore it was, to me, logical that they did well in French Open, and they continued here on the good run.
Yeah. Denmark, they lost in the semi-final to Govi Shemantam Wikiong, who went on to win their first ever Super Series title. Since then, they haven't won a match, the Malaysians.
No.
So into the mid-game interval, the Indonesians with a two-point advantage.
Disheartened the Danes as they went to the interval, but we've seen them crawl back before, and therefore we shouldn't rule that out. But definitely the advantage with the two Indonesian players. Good movement by Carsten Mogensen. The Danes. We saw Mathias Bohr hunting that at the net. And getting a little bit lucky with the net cord there. And he's been covering those third shots extremely well, I think. The better thing for the Indonesian to do is to play it to the backcourt player when ball is serving. Gets the rally going for them.
Oh, that's
going long.
Oh, it's called in. They're challenging.
Yeah. I couldn't really see it because it landed behind the back of Carsten Mogensen, so.
Call in.
Yeah, it's in. It's in.
Definitely in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just the flight looked as if it was going to go way long.
Yeah, plumb on the line.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over. 12-4.
Very alert.
13-12.
They more or less have to go for these 50-50 shots. The Danes got to win the service situation and control the rally.
Oh my goodness.
That was the second one almost on the blue. Yeah, that smash or drop that
that's right.
Was directed at the service judge. So many other good actions from Kevin Tsukamulyo.
Ah! 15-13.
In many ways, it's fantastic that we can have four players on court that are 2 and 2, so different.
Yeah.
Two players that are not that tall, and then two very tall players. So just have to use your advantage to the best.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Long.
That's too long. No, oh, what a rally.
14-15.
That's the first jump lift I've seen.
Mm. Matthias Bow, who made the error. Look at that! Full pirouette on the backhand smash. No wonder he's happy with that.
His ball, but in the end, not enough. Comes here.
Yeah.
But we talked about in the women's doubles this about having players that can fill the roles equally well, and I think we see an example of it here, where perhaps there's a preferred front court and back court player, but they are very, very good in the opposite role as well, both Sukumuljo and Gideon.
Quick onto those half court flat pushes, isn't he? Sukumuljo. Three points away from a third Super Series title of the year. Don't believe it.
Now
he's pushed in long.
It's over.
Well, the Indonesians, they must have had about three or four opportunities to finish off the rally. Well, not really getting the feel of the rally from that replay. But quite clearly the longest rally of the match so far, 50 shots. Had an age in between 16, the end of that rally and the beginning of this. It's desperately disappointing we didn't get to see more of that rally in replay.
That was the best rally of the match.
Quite easily.
That is over 1960.
Unreturnable. A shot from Gideon.
Match points have arrived. Four opportunities to win their third Super Series title of the year. Their third in total.
Opportunity to win it there.
Mm, yeah.
They've stayed in it, the Danes, but it's only actually after that run of six straight points in the first game that you had the feeling that they were sort of on the way to win this match. Apart from that, I think the Indonesians have been dominant.
Challenging. I'm convinced that was in. You know, on that previous rally, Steen, as we wait for Hawkeye, I felt that the Indonesians were wanting to win the match with a showboating shot.
Yeah.
And that, I think, could be very costly.
It could.
Here we go. I'm sure this is in. Yeah.
Yeah. We also saw again some of the stuff that makes them so difficult to play, these two guys here, and that is that they sort of forced the Danes to win that rally three times.
Yeah.
Because they saved two really big opportunities.
Yeah. Points, of course, for the Indonesians. Two more opportunities. Just one more opportunity. What a good serve, though, from Carsten Mortensen.
I mean, it's a pair that the Indonesians have never beaten. They're recently upcoming pair of the Indonesians, so there's a lot of pairs like this.
Yeah.
But it's one of the good pairs that they haven't beaten yet. So only one rally away from it now. but
well, it wasn't called. An ace on the flick serve, and it's 20 all. An extra points required. Four match points have come and gone. Do they have the nerve?
And it looks like Gideon, he looks like he just wants to get it over with.
Yeah. Series title of the year for Gideon Marcus Fanaldi and Kevin Sanjaya Sokomoljo. For the Danes, obvious disappointments, the two-time former champions in their fourth
match
final
one,
here
Marcus
today.
Fernandi, Gideon, Kevin, Sanjaya Sokomoljo, 31-18, 22-20.
Just under 50 minutes. Oh, crikey, I was wondering he didn't do his back in with that little celebration there. But they played well today, did the Indonesians. They played well all week, and there is confirmation. 21-18, 22-20, and the China Open title belongs to Gideon and Sokomoljo.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Taihua China Open 2015, part of mainland BWF World Super Series Premier. The Taihua Cup Men's Doubles awarding ceremony will start shortly. Please welcome the winners.
获得泰格2016年中国羽毛球公开赛。
So the Danes, in their fourth final here for a second time, have to settle for second best. But what a year they've had. The Indonesian pair, a third Super Series title of the year. The first was in India, the second win was in Australia, and here they win their first Premier Super Series title in their first Premier final. In fact, the first time beyond a quarter final of a Premier event. So Mr. Cheng Yong presenting the trophies.
The bouquet and check will be presented by Chen Chong, the Vice President of Taihot Group.
Mr. Cheng Chong, the Vice President of Taihot Group, presenting the checks. And the MetLife Life souvenir will be presented by Mr. Chen Hua. Look disappointed, but they should be proud because today was a 24th Super Series tournament final and an 8th Premier Super Series tournament final. They have had remarkable consistency, but they were beaten today by the better pair. Gideon Marcus Fanaldi and Kevin Sanjaya.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the first award ceremony for Taihot Cup men's doubles.
Well, our three finals so far, and the title's going to players from three different nations. It is still mathematically possible that all five matches could go to players from different countries, because if Jan Jorgensen was to win the men's singles against the world and Olympic champion Chen Long, and then if the Chinese pair were to win the mixed doubles, it is still possible. But looking at, well, we don't want to see the men's doubles ranking again. We'd really like to see the men's singles. Here we go. Sun Wanho will lose his number one position because win or lose today's final. And Jan Jorgensen will go to number one on the Destination Dubai rankings, pushing the two players above him down one place each. Victor Axelsen, after his semi-final, will go up three places to number four on that list. The Olympic champion Chen Long isn't anywhere on the list. He's 20 at the moment, but he will be invited to the Super Series finals as the reigning Olympic champion. Well, as far as the men's singles draw is concerned, just five different nations involved by quarterfinal stage, four seeds. By the time we got to semi-finals, three different nations, we had two Danes involved. And the top three seeds that started the competition, because last year's champion the number one seed Li Chongwei unable to defend his title and withdrew from the competition. So here we are, Jano Jorgensen, the beaten finalist from 2009, up against Chen Long, the reigning world and Olympic champion. Chen Long, number two seed today, appearing in his sixth final here at his home Super Series events.